Did you know this? Halloween has become the second biggest holiday for decorating right behind Christmas. In fact, last year Americans spent $1.3 billion on Halloween decorations alone. And this year, take that figure, add in your candy and your costumes, and Americans will spend, get this, $5 billion. But do you know why you're spending the money? Because Hallmark says you should, that's why. Well, tomorrow night, the ghouls and goblins will be up on the streets, gobbling up all the candy. What is it all about? Our local expert, Dr. Liam Murphy from Sac State's Anthropology Department, has some of the real reasons behind it. Good morning.
Good morning.
So, from what I understand, you can blame my people, the Irish, for all of this.
Yeah, certainly that plays a significant role in that. My people, too, incidentally.
Yeah. So how far do we go back to where the origins of All Hallows' Eve came up to be?
Well, All Hallows' Eve itself is a Catholic holiday. It's the All Hallows' Eve, the night before the Feast of All Saints, or the Feast of All Hallows, as it was called in the medieval world. But if you want to look at the Irish origins of the holiday, you really have to go back much further than that, probably to pre-Christian times. There was a significant harvest festival, Samhain, held every November, the end of November, and this marked a transition between the summer and the winter. So it was a time of crossing a threshold between this world.
So was there an actual, as part of the festival, was there an actual dressing up? And
no, that comes later. Mm-hmm. Although some of the elements we associate with Halloween, the lights, the nighttime, the outdoors, I mean, the things we kind of take for granted. I mean, Halloween's an interesting holiday. It's an outdoor holiday.
Right.
A lot of the other holidays that we associate with the Christian calendar, for instance, are indoor
in very holy places.
Mm-hmm, in very holy places.
So,
right.
At what point did we take it and just ruin it? In your opinion, Liam, when did we really just kind of take it to all of this stuff?
Well, you know, the people that transformed Halloween from a sort of debauched nighttime kind of holiday to a sort of quaint children's festival. That didn't really happen until towards the end of the Second World War.
Really?
And that was a strategy that was devised by a number of different charitable associations and parents groups around the country to give their kids something else to do besides vandalism and teenage drinking and things like that. Right up until the Second World War, Halloween was kind of not a very pleasant
evening. Permission to just kind of go crazy for a night.
The license was was given, and you know, police departments used to dread that. Used to dread Halloween.
Some would say they still do.
I think they do, and mm-hmm. So every Halloween, I certainly don't want to encourage anybody, but every Halloween, if you read the newspapers the next day and check online, you'll see that sometime somewhere. The night before, you'll find there's disturbances.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
What candy do you give out?
I like Reese's.
Or do you give a lecture?
I give a lecture.
Yeah.
I actually do. I give a lecture.
Is that the trick or the treat?
It depends on who you ask.
Yeah.
For me, it's a treat.
Well, thank you, Liam.
I love doing it.
We appreciate you coming in today. Very interesting stuff.
Thank you very much, Judah.